So they say a picture is worth a thousand words. So if that's true, what is a video worth? Hey everybody, what's going on? This is Clayton from FreeUp. And in today's video, I want to be showing you how to use one of my favorite productivity tools, the Loom Screen Recorder. Now, this is a fantastic tool that's going to help you make short videos for a ton of different reasons. So if you stick around to the end, I'll show you how we use it in our business and how you can use it too. So let's hop over to my computer and I'll show you how it works. All right, so we are here on my computer and I'm gonna be showing you guys a little quick tutorial of Loom. Now, first thing is like, what is Loom? So it's essentially a video app. You can make really quick little videos of either yourself or your computer screen. And this can be very helpful in a lot of different situations. If you just wanna send somebody a quick video, sometimes it's a lot better than typing out a huge email. They even talk about it right here on their website. Or sometimes you can send a quick video instead of like actually going to a meeting. I know once your business starts going, everyone wants to do meetings with you. It takes a ton of time. So instead of doing that, you can do that. You can actually get your whole team on here instead of your just personal account. So there's lots of different stuff you can do with Loom. And one of the cool things about it is in terms of pricing, you can actually start for free. And I think this is how they got a ton of users in the beginning. So you can actually get a free account. It's really simple. Or if you want more video storage and stuff, you can start getting into the paid ones. But for today's purposes, we'll just start with this like little basic free account. So pretty simple. You can actually just hit this big button that's called Get Loom for Free. You can start like that and you can sign up a few different ways. I already have an account, so I'm gonna show you how I just signed up with Google. Now, they do have a way for you to download an actual desktop app, but I just prefer to use this Chrome extension here because it's just always sitting right there when I'm using, you know, browsing around the internet or answering my emails, super easy. So with that said, let me hop into my account and I can show you what it looks like. Another way to install Loom is just straight from the Chrome Web Store. Now you can find this link on the Loom website, but I'm just gonna start right here and show you. This is probably the most common thing that you wanna do. So you can see I search for Loom for Chrome. Go ahead and I'm just gonna add it to Chrome right there. It's gonna ask you a few questions. You can hit add extension right there. And then it should install it. And it's actually gonna bring me over to my personal library. So this is cool. So I can see all the videos that I have already done. If you're just brand new, you'll need to start creating videos. So one thing I do like to do is I love to have it, you know, right up here and very usable. So if I click this button over here and I hit this little pin, right, this pin extension, it's gonna keep it right there so I can always use it. And that's super helpful if I'm just on the go, I'm writing emails, I'm doing things, I can always just open it up. Boom, it's right there, start recording a video. Let's say I wanna record a quick little video. Let me just walk you through what you can see here. So I'm gonna hit this button right here and it's gonna load this up. Now you can see a couple different things. Number one, you can see my beautiful face down here in this corner and I can keep it like that. I can make it bigger, you know, make it really big. Wow, that's really big. you can keep it there. If you wanna move it around, you can, or, you know, if you don't want to record your face at all, you can actually just push screen only and it'll bring up your little picture. And if you don't even want anything there, you can just like get rid of it. Or you can just do cam only. So it'll just record my beautiful face right there. So for the most part, a lot of times, you know, I don't need myself to be in there. I might be in my pajamas making these videos. So I'm going to go ahead and just hit the X. That way I'm just using this right here. Now, back over here on these options. So if you wanna not see your face, you can do that. Now, I can record the full desktop or just the current tab. So for instance, if I don't want all this stuff up here inside of my video, I can do that. One thing to really, really make sure, this will mess you up a bunch of times, is make sure this microphone audio is working and that is the actual microphone input that you want. You know, if you're using Bluetooth headphones or anything like that, you wanna make sure that you're capturing the right audio because you don't want to start recording a video and then it goes totally to crap, right? Because you didn't actually record the good audio. So want to make sure that this microphone audio is doing well. Now, let me just walk you through the advanced options real quick. So you can see here, microphone source, external microphone. You know, I could change this if I had a couple microphones hooked up or just want to use my computer mic. The control menu, you can turn this on and off. So you notice there down the left-hand corner, it turns on and off. Recording countdown, I can turn that on. It's going to give me a few seconds before I actually start recording. And then that's it. So let me just hide those advanced options. And then I'll show you what it looks like when you're recording a video, okay? So just hit start recording. It'll come up like this and it'll ask you, Chrome is gonna ask you if you wanna share your screen
or just the application window, right? So if I wanted to share, I'm going to be switching through different applications, you know, maybe showing something like that, then I'll want to definitely record my entire screen. If I'm just recording, you know, what's going on in this app, I can do that. So a lot of times I just hit share entire screen. So you want to do that, you want to click on that, highlight it, and push share. All right, so now I am recording a video. And you can see down here I have a little control menu, so I can hit pause or whatever I want, start and stop the video. I can see there's a little blinking red light right here that's going to tell me that I'm actually recording. So I can go ahead and, you know, make my video, record the screen, talk about whatever I want, like how FreeUp is such a great place if you want to hire freelancers. You can come here and we can help you out with that. But after I'm done sharing my screen, then I can just come down here and hit stop sharing, or I could actually click that button right up there. It's going to stop the video recording and immediately start uploading it. And this is one of the best things about Loom, is that your video is like nearly instantly ready for someone else to watch. I can literally take this link right here and start sharing it right now with anybody. And you know, if you've ever used any other video programs, you probably noticed that, you know, it's kind of a pain. You gotta record the video, and then you gotta like go to your website, and then you gotta find the upload button, and you upload it, and you wait a long time. Well, that's not like what Loom is about at all. I mean, Loom is so fast, so I can literally just share this immediately after recording. So there's that. Now, there's a few things on this screen that you're gonna wanna check out. First thing is, it'll automatically create a title based on wherever you were, but I might just say like, this is my demo screen recording or something like that, right? You can change that however you'd like. Now, they have a couple of tools that can help you kind of trim up your video. So I can come over here and, you know, I could actually start trimming, and I could, you know, say like, oh, I didn't really like this intro. I can cut that off, or I can trim up the ending if I didn't like that. So it has a little bit of video editing, but this is not meant to be a video editing tool. This is really meant to be just a relatively quick way to record good videos. So, but you do have a little bit of editing power in there. All right, now, like I said, when you're ready to share this video after you're done with it, you can really easily just take this link, and let me just show you, like, as if I were in incognito mode, if I were somebody else. This is kind of what it looks like to the person that you share it with. So it's real simple, and they can just go ahead and hit play video right there. And they could even like leave some comments or download the video or whatever they want. So it's a pretty easy way to share it. You can share it nearly instantly. Now, there are a couple options in terms of that sharing. So let's say if you wanted to add a password, they actually have some privacy features over here. So I can just add a password right there, pretty simple. And then if you want to share it somewhere else, there's a couple more ways. So you can copy the link, you can have a link GIF, you can actually embed it on a website if you want, share it to a couple social media things, or even in Gmail. Now, one thing that's kind of cool is that if you're actually in Gmail, you would just be normally just sharing this link, but Gmail actually creates a little GIF for you, a little kind of preview of it. So when you're sharing an email, it looks pretty cool. So let me show you that right now. I just copied the normal regular link, normal sharing link, and I paste it into Gmail. And look what it does. It automatically brings this up, has you know, the title right there, has a link to the video, and then creates a little GIF, animated image of what it's like. So it works really great if you're sharing these things in Gmail. One thing that's cool is that Loom is actually going to give you notifications when your videos start to get viewed. So if, let's say, you send an important video to someone and you want to see if they viewed it, you can actually see if they have viewed your video. They'll give you a little notification. And not just in there, but actually in your own Loom account. If we were to go back here, you know, I can actually see the activity feed, and I can see, you know, all the people that have watched my videos, when they watched them, all that kind of stuff, if they're signed in, or it'll just say somebody like anonymously looked at it. Now, in this personal library, there's a couple things that you can do. I just mostly keep all my videos in there, but if you want to organize them, you can actually organize them into folders. So it's pretty simple. Come up here, put a new folder. I'll just say Clayton's folder. And then I can start just adding videos in here. I can record new videos. I can actually add in previous videos that I've done. So it's another way to just keep all your videos organized if you want. A lot of times I'm mostly just using these as short little clips, so I don't need to keep them super organized. They're only usually viewed a couple times in terms of the way that I use it. So how do you actually use Loom? Well, there's a lot of different use cases for this. So I'll just say that the first one that I use a lot is literally just getting rid of, you know, long emails. Like if I'm about ready to type out a huge email, instead of doing that, I'll actually just record a quick little video because I can really show somebody something. Now, Loom has a bunch of different use cases here. You can check it out. So engineering, if you're doing sales, if you're doing recruiting, if you're doing design, I use it all the time for design, you know, critiques and feedback. Marketing, I use it all the time for marketing. Customer support, this is amazing if you have, you know, customer support agents. And sometimes, you know, you're trying to show somebody how to do something on your website, or you're trying to show somebody, you know, how to solve a bug or whatever. Actually getting a Loom video is 1,000 times better than actually just typing out a 10-step process, something like that. Customer success, similar thing. Leadership. So check out this page on the Loom website. It's going to give you a bunch of ideas how you can use it. But for me, I love just this ability to come up here, hit this one button, start recording it, and I can send somebody a short little video as opposed to typing out a huge thing or getting on a call or anything like that. It saved me a ton of time. So guys, check it out, loom.com. You are going to love this thing as you start using it in your personal daily life and your business, and I hope it brings you a lot of success and speeds up your productivity.
Hey everybody, hope you liked that video, and if you did, make sure to hit the like button. That helps us know we should keep making this type of content. And if you want more trainings and tutorials that's going to help your business run faster, hit that subscribe button as well so you can keep up to date with all of our latest content. So again, this is Clayton from FreeUp, and we'll see you on the next video. Cheers. Hey, So again, guys, this is Clayton from FreeUp, and we...